Hello everyone, this time we are going to look into the most talked about tech trend, decentralized finance, and get to know more about its benefits and transformative use cases. Let's start. What is DeFi? Decentralized finance, or simply DeFi, refers to an alternative finance system. It relies on blockchain for executing numerous types of financial activities, such as borrowing, lending, capitalizing on price movements, and trading crypto. The main purpose of DeFi is to provide a viable and more effective solution to centralized legacy systems that majorly depends on intermediaries. These days, DeFi solutions are being built upon all major blockchains, yet it is Ethereum that currently leads the DeFi economy sector. Most of the protocols and decentralized apps that run on the Ethereum blockchain have found a solid market fit and established large user communities. Before DeFi, there was just CeFi, which stands for Centralized Finance. CeFi versus DeFi. So, what's the difference between CeFi and DeFi? Both of them aim to provide a range of financial services. However, in CeFi, users trust people to manage funds and conduct the business's services, while in DeFi, users trust the technology to execute on services being offered. For sure, there are other differences between DeFi and CeFi. The major ones are presence, absence of intermediaries, custodial status, access, and permission. Presence, absence of intermediaries. The key difference between CeFi and DeFi is the presence or absence of intermediaries. While CeFi heavily relies on middlemen to regulate transactions, DeFi is based on autonomous and self-executing smart contracts that can easily secure an agreement. Custodial status. DeFi and CeFi also differ in their custodial statuses. They determine whether a user has a partial or full control over their assets. In CeFi, there is a third party that looks after money on behalf of the user, while in DeFi only the user has total control over their funds. Access and permission. With CeFi, users are frequently required to undergo a Know Your Customer procedure to access services. This means that they have to provide their personal data prior to gaining access to the desired services. DeFi, on the other hand, allows users to connect directly to services using just a wallet. They are not obliged to reveal personal information or deposit funds. Still, many experts in the domain believe that weak KYC processes are a setback for DeFi. They also think that introduction of KYC and AML regulations doesn't imply that DeFi would lose its inherent value. Instead, they will help bring in new customers and provide much better security of the user's personal data. Therefore, it's likely that in the future, KYC in DeFi will be a new normal. In addition, DeFi can be accessed at any time and from any location. You only need to have a stable internet connection. What are the benefits of DeFi? And based on this, we can now summarize all the benefits that DeFi offers to its users, namely transparency. The distributed ledger makes it possible to view information about all activities taking place on the blockchain network. Sovereignty. DeFi market participants can keep custody of their own assets and control of their personal data. Safety. Thanks to tamper-proof data coordination across a blockchain's decentralized architecture, DeFi guarantees top security and auditability. Interoperability. With DeFi, developers and product teams possess the ability to build on top of existing protocols, customize interfaces, and integrate third-party applications. This is why DeFi protocols are often referred to as money legos. Availability. The distributed nature of DeFi platforms and protocols makes them available all over the world. Thus, literally everyone can engage in banking-like services. What are the cons of DeFi? In spite of its multiple benefits, DeFi has drawbacks too, such as scalability, uncertainty, liquidity concerns, shared responsibility, as well as smart contract issues. All of those drawbacks are closely related to the blockchain, since the troubles with the blockchain itself are responsible for fueling the cons of DeFi. The good news is that improvements are being made every day. The experts in the domain give due consideration to the problems and work out effective strategies and solutions to ensure smooth and frictionless functioning with the entire DeFi space. Plus, Ethereum 2.0 is poised to bring about positive changes to the DeFi ecosystem and tackle its major challenges. Besides, there are other protocols such as Raiden and Truebit that are set to tackle Ethereum scalability issues. If these solutions fall into place, Ethereum's DeFi experiments will have an even better chance of becoming real products, potentially even going mainstream. Where can DeFi be applied? DeFi is a good option for addressing multiple issues including friction, document forgery, digital identity, fraud, unwanted delays, exchange hacks, and private keys compromisation. What are the most notable DeFi use cases and projects? The famous DeFi boom of 2020 served as a trigger of remarkable progress in the DApp development. Back in 2020, there was an increase of almost 1,200% in the total DApp volume. The majority of those apps were created with the help of Ethereum, which still remains a widely used blockchain in DeFi development. Almost every day, new types of DeFi projects are proliferating. Let's look into the most profitable segments. As for decentralized lending and borrowing platforms, these are regarded as the most remarkable developments on the DeFi landscape. The most outstanding examples include Earn Finance, Compound, Aave, and MakerDAO. DeFi lending and borrowing platforms let users supply and lock their funds into smart contracts from where other users can borrow and pay interest on them. In addition, each loan is collateralized by crypto. Decentralized exchanges such as Uniswap, 0x, and Kyber enable trustless P2P trading. They directly connect cryptocurrency or token buyers and sellers across a global liquidity pool. DEXs execute trades via smart contracts that provide the transaction security and allow users to trade simply by connecting with their wallets. DeFi payments. The rationale behind DeFi payment solutions including OmsGo, Request Network, and Seller Network is to create an open finance ecosystem to facilitate institutions and the underbanked and unbanked populations. Plus, DeFi payments offer secure transactions which are powered by programmable smart contracts. DAOs, decentralized autonomous organizations, are companies governed in a decentralized manner via smart contracts. A number of popular protocols such as Maker and Compound have launched DAOs to fundraise, manage financial operations, and decentralized governance in the community. The main idea behind DAOs is to provide a large community of contributors with the ability to participate in the DAO's governance and future development. Prediction markets. Blockchain-based prediction markets enable users to vote and trade value on outcome of certain events. For example, OGA, a DeFi betting platform, presents information about prediction markets related to election results, sports games, economic events, and more. Saving apps. There are many DeFi apps that provide interest-bearing accounts. They allow users to earn more than traditional savings accounts, depending on a dynamic interest rate tied to supply and demand. Popular savings apps include Argent Dharma. Pool Together, for example, is a no-loss savings game in which participants get all their money back, regardless of whether they win or not. DeFi margin trading. In traditional finance, traders usually borrow funds from brokers to leverage their trades. In DeFi, margin trading is normally based on decentralized, non-custodial lending protocols such as Compound and DYDX. Given that smart contracts can fully automate traditional brokerage activity, there was an increase in the number of autonomous money markets in the entire DeFi ecosystem. As you see, DeFi can exert a powerful impact on various facets, and it's safe to say the decentralized finance will be gradually spreading its influence on many more segments. While DeFi is still in its early days, it has proven to be a powerful tool capable of forcing a number of positive changes. DeFi continues to be a lucrative venture, and its enormous benefits such as transparency, interoperability, and sovereignty translate to multiple powerful use cases. Though some people might be skeptical about DeFi's wider adoption, one thing is clear for sure: DeFi is here and it's here to stay. To learn more about DeFi and other blockchain trends, visit our blog at pixelplex.io, where our top blockchain experts share their knowledge and expertise. Also, write in the comments below which topics you would like us to cover in our future episodes. Thanks for watching this video. Bye!